Bobby, what have you done?
I want to get Vic's take on this, too. Yeah. I think you shared a little bit too much.
I have the tweet.
Really?
And I have the sister.
Wait, do you think the same, too?
I don't know what they're talking about.
Oh, yeah. Bobby sent out a tweet yesterday. Justin, go ahead and read what the tweet said.
Bobby WBAL writes yesterday at 8:30 p.m., feels like my younger sister is averaging at least one Hinge date meetup per week. I feel like she's picky, but older brother's going to have a heart attack in his 20s. She immediately responds to it, Bobby!
In all caps.
And the minute after you tweet out, and that's the moment you realize your sister still uses Twitter.
Which I really genuinely didn't think she did.
How old is she?
She's 23.
Okay.
So we should say that they live down in Fells Point. You live in the same building. She lives above you or something.
Yeah.
So you basically put her on blast saying that, A, she's on Hinge, which is a dating app, and B, that she's just going out on all these dates.
I don't know.
You called your sister a whore.
No, I did not. I didn't want to say it. I'm not going that far. She's going out trying to meet someone.
She's a modern woman.
She's a grown woman. She can go have a drink with a gentleman.
Okay.
That's fine, but
she can many people she wants.
And let's just say this. She respects herself. She respects the family.
That makes one of us.
She's always very, very mindful of that.
Or are we just close?
Let's just say that.
Are we two of you?
No, I'm the oldest of four.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, he's the older brother.
She's the only girl.
Yeah. So he's protective. But are we just old school, old guys that maybe this is the makeup of the modern woman. This is what they do.
They get on the Tinder Snatch and the Bumblefly.
And they just go out on dates.
I still want to meet a woman down at the malt shop.
Right.
throw my coat across a puddle and then get her pregnant a week later.
And then talk about communism.
Maybe we sound stupid.
I had a couple female listeners reach out to me privately saying, that's free publicity for your sister. I said, heck yeah.
They don't want that type of publicity.
I like it. Let's get her take on it, though. She's ready to rock.
I like that you did that. I have two sisters, so I would probably do. I'm very protective.
Do you hear that lovely chuckle in the background? Because that is Bobby's sister joining us.
Oh, really?
Good morning. Good morning. Hi, Tori.
Listen,
how are you?
Tori, are you mad that he put you on blast like that a little bit?
Yeah. First of all, I got it like a Snapchat from a high school friend, and he was like, your brother's tweet is hilarious, and I didn't even know what he had tweeted, so I was like, and I don't really go on Twitter that much, but I saw my account, so I was like, all right, I logged on quickly, and I saw that, and I'm like, are you kidding me? And I didn't even text him right away. I didn't text him until the morning. And then I saw on my commute in the morning that he posted it on Instagram, too.
In a roundabout way,
do you feel like he called you a floozy?
He's just putting your business out there. People don't need to know you're going on Tinder dates every other day.
Well, no, also, it was just a huge exaggeration because I coincidentally went on one last week and then this week, but that's been it. No more in Baltimore.
Who was this week? Who was that guy?
Well, his name was Lou. last week was fine. Both of them were fine.
They were fine. Were they gentlemen?
Yeah, they both were.
And you meet him in a public place, obviously, right? We got to give him the whole thing.
Place.
Don't have any more than two drinks.
Mm-mm.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure everyone knows where you're at.
Don't leave your drink unattended.
Yep. But
am I missing anything?
Tuds, you said earlier this week is going to a second one, right?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Bobby. What's that name again?
Yeah, did you just call her?
Tugs?
Did you call her Tugs?
Yeah, that's
do not call her Tugs.
They call me Tugs. I told the guy, too. I was like, just so you know, my brothers call me Tugs. And he's like, so, where'd you get that nickname from?
Are you the only Tugs? Is she the only sister?
Do you give a rough hand job?
How many brothers?
Three.
It can't be. You're not the only overprotective brother, right?
Brother.
We all are, aren't we?
I feel like it's worse because the other two are younger, but I think they try to follow Bobby's footsteps, so... Right. Who knows? They'll probably be just like them.
It's been like that forever.
Let's pick a new one. Okay, because
spell it for me. I can't hear what you're saying. T-U-D?
Yeah.
Oh, it's not G.
Oh,
it's
a D.
Yeah, no,
D.
I heard G.
Oh, that takes away my horrible joke.
Yeah, I was going to say, man, people can't wait to get the check when they're going out with Tugs. So, are any of the men that you've dated recently, are any of them in the running for a second?
Just that one that I met Wednesday. Yeah, he wants do something tomorrow, so we'll see, I guess.
All right. Well, got Bobby looking after you.
Just as long as you know that Bobby is in control of your life. I almost wanted to
respond to the tweet instead of saying Bobby. I was going to say, how many Hinge dates do you average a week? Because he's 10 times.
Good question.
I knew you were going to come after me about that.
Wow. Bobby, you on Hinge?
But I thought I would be a nice sister and not do that. So
now, what? Describe Hinge to us.
Oh God!
Where is it on the rankings? Like we know, like Tinder is like you swipe left, swipe right, and if you match, you go bang.
Yeah.
Then there's Bumble, who you have to be, you got to have mutual friends or something like that.
Yeah. Then there's Grindr,
Zulily, if you're into bestiality.
There you go. Now, so what does Hinge do that Tinder doesn't?
Yeah, right. What's their gimmick?
It's supposed to be a little bit classier. Okay. It's supposed to be more questions,
Got it.
I think Tinder's got a bad, at least it did in college for Bobby and I. It's got a worse reputation. Yeah. Now I feel like mm-hmm. Hinge is the new thing,
Tugs and Jerk, the siblings from the Trossett family. Well, thank you for taking the time with us, and we'll try and curtail his putting you on blastedness on the Twitter. And please just close your DMs. You do not understand the Pandora's box that this is going to open with every last one of our just mole covered goblins coming out to try and hit on Bobby's sister. So, Tori, thank you so much and make your account private, okay?
Thanks for having me.
Love you, kid. Have a good day.
There she goes. Sweet Tugs.
And her name's Victoria, obviously.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
What do you think about that? What Bobby did.
What do you mean?
Well, do you think he should have?
I don't have sisters, so I don't know. Okay. I'm familiar with this. I'm the youngest of three boys, and my mom just takes a beating from us.
Yeah.
In terms of making fun of the only woman in the house, it was me and my two brothers making fun of our mom.
And so. I know it came from a place of love because you're the first guy to put the head down, hands up at some guy that might run afoul of your beloved sister. But I got to tell you, you need to go back to the drawing board on that nickname, brother. You got to come up with another one.
Did you catch what she said there about the difference between Twitter and Instagram, the importance to her, right? She didn't really care. She said she didn't hit me back when it was on Twitter.
Right,
and then I reposted it on Instagram
because
I knew
it
would generate responses. And that set her off. That's what set her off right there.
Do you have a nickname? Do you have some sort of little...
They call me... They call me like Buck, B-U-C-K.
What's that come
from? Buck. we all have very interesting nicknames. You got Wags is the youngest. Mm-hmm. We got Yoy K, the middle.
I'm the hymen.
Tori's Tutty. And they'll call me Beetro or things like that. Mm-hmm. There's really no rhyme or reason to it.
Do your parents have weird nicknames too?
They call my dad, so his name's Frank.
Okay.
That backwards is Narf, so we call him Narfy.
You grew up on a compound. Your family was in a cult,
really,
and you don't know
Narf.
It.
That's really stuck, too. Like, his friends call him that.
They'll call
him
Narf, too. Yeah, sure. Yeah.
Narf.
I imagine the Trossett family going away on a retreat every summer in a cabin and just putting their heads together, trying to figure out nicknames.
Oh, yeah.
They just are in a cabin being like, all right, 2020's coming. We need new nicknames for each other. All right, this year you're going to be the pepper grinder. And you're going to be my slutty cheese or whatever the hell else you guys come up with.
Seriously,
We had the family that lived on the end of our street. Their dad would take us camping, right? And the first time he took us camping, he couldn't see really well, and he put too much lighter fluid on the fire and burned all of his eyebrows off.
Damn.
So for the rest of that man's life, he was known as the camper. The whole family were the campers. So there was big camper, little camper, everybody's camper.
Dang.
And when Bobby goes on vacation, man, they have a pretty great time.
Bending down while something's being stuffed in my mouth.
They do all kinds of stuff when they're out there. They spend time with men.
And I'm like, who is that? That is a massive dude over there. He's like...
Wow, it just got dirty.
It just got dirty.
And maybe when you get in the river...
Soaking wet poles?
When you get out. Oh, Bobby.
Where do you go? I'm stunned. I'm sitting here.
This is the sound bites, man. This is...
is that what that was?
Welcome in. Yeah, welcome in.
Yeah, I mean, Vic Henley, Magoobies this weekend. We might
look
as
at
well.
Can you see that screen over there? Stand up and look at that screen. Look at that.
See the pink? Pink?
It that's, runs deep, man.
That's all him. That's all.
Oh, really?
Bobby
all
out sound, of context.
All sound bites.
Would you like a pink?
You got to take a picture of that and tweet that out.
Vic, would you like a pink sampler spoon of what we have?
Yeah, give him a sampler of Bobby.
And here you go, Vic Henley at Magoobies. Oh.
Dirty, hard nose.
He's flowing right
and
now.
I'm like, who is that? That is a massive dude over there. That,
we
like,
have tissues in here?
You know, he's got a pile of guys around him, so I wasn't about to get involved in that. He just got me in the forehead. This feels massive. She pulled it out and she was ready to go. I did slide up in there.
He can handle it.
So I would grind all night. Very deep in tight ends. And that fluid almost never runs out, by the way. Here I come. I'm sure there's going to be a lot more to come. Reaches completion. An absolute load. 12 is a big number. I'm going to take a train.
Soaking wet balls.
It just got dirty.
Covered in that white stuff.
Come in and just
covered
burst.
In that white stuff.
Are you going to come with me?
Swift and thorough and quick.
Coming on Saturday night.
Thought it was funny.
We should
enjoy
do it together.
He stopped by moments after drilling that
young unit.
He stopped by moments after drilling
young
that
unit. Very deep in tight ends.
You know what you and I both love?
Those sub-6-foot dudes.
We could take our pants off.
That opens up some things.
That makes this one feel
a whole
humongous.
Young unit.
I'm sure there's going to be a lot more to come.
Young unit.
See how much juice he has. There's going to be a lot of
locked and loaded.
Rushing
he's got
through.
A pile of guys around him, so I wasn't about to get involved in that.
We had a discussion about his groin.
That.
My masterwork.
That is, that, I was going to say, that's a lot of work.
You know, this is
very, very tedious.
This is a tradition, Vic Henley, because this man took over for a legend and in his own right is becoming one slowly because the man prior to him, the last time you were in here, was Keith Mills.
Yeah.
All
right.
And if you don't mind, Vic.
Swallowed.
I'm not a big sack guy, but I'll still be bending over.
Lube that bad boy.
Anytime you can go inside something, it's a pretty cool thing.
Hey, here's what they can do. Suck it all, right?
Balls are hitting me in the head.
I'm serious. This long.
That meat is sensational.
Your end is probably tighter than his.
I just kind of hunkered down there and watched 7-8 guys at one time.
Is
you
it
know?
Hard?
They strapped it on.
Bofa, these nuts.
Just bang some of those dongers.
I love the way junk hangs around the junk.
Ah, come on out here, big boy.
You have 600 pounds worth of monster beef coming at you.
Those guys sucking it up and doing that, I'm
you
telling
have a big
you,
butt,
man.
Josh.
Sack daddy.
A lot of guys can jack it.
Sack daddy.
Raw. Raw as they come.
Sack daddy.
You suck it and take it.
Sack daddy.
He's pounding the meat.
Sack daddy.
Whacking that thing around,
sack
Josh.
Sack daddy.
I'm telling you, that's brilliant. That's so hard to do.
Yeah.
I'd have to have a pound of pot to get that done.
It had been a minute, too. We hadn't run that back.
God, we haven't hit Keith's in a while. I've missed it.
There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.